Hey, this is Glendon Cameron, and I'm going to do this video because I'm about to educate some people on some things that I knew, but I didn't know that other people didn't know this stuff, because I got a flurry of comments about one of my no eBay, no Amazon videos. I thought I was going to leave it alone, but I think it's time to educate people. I think it's time to expand concepts, to expand perspectives, and to give you something that you really need to know. Now, what I'm going to do, the first person, the first 30 minutes after this video is uploaded, because I'll be watching to guess where Amazon ranks in the world's biggest public companies. Amazon is publicly traded, and it's an international company, so it's in the mix, right? Because people talk as if Amazon is the only company in the fucking world. Or eBay. So let's begin. Now, I have studied companies since I was in high school. Now, also, there's going to be a little quiz in here. Because as I go through this, I want you to see who will notice some things and put it in the comments. All right. So right here, this is 2015. This list was created last year, and we're going to look at the world's biggest public companies. Now, should be no surprise, the number one largest company in the world that's publicly traded is ICBC in China with $3.3 trillion in assets. Yeah, they're up there. They're kind of crazy. All right. So let's just go down the list. Now, once again, guess where Amazon is. I've asked six people today and everyone was wrong. And I'm not talking about a little wrong. I'm talking about way off the mark. So you got ICB. And also, I want you to look at these companies. They all do stuff. China Construction Bank. I mean, this big growth that's going on in China, because if you're looking for the American middle class, it moved to China because that's what's going to happen. The prosperity, all the things that we experienced in the 50s, the 60s, the 70s, the 80s, yeah, it's kind of tapered off toward the 80s, somewhat toward the 90s. That's what's going on in China right now. Agricultural Bank of China, Bank of China. So in the world's largest companies, 1, 2, 3, and 4 are based in China. Now look at number five, Warren Buffett, fifth largest company in the world. Warren Buffett, Berkshire Hathaway, fifth in the world. Think about that. Now, JP Morgan Chase, which is a bank. There's a lot of banks on here. Exxon, been around forever. PetroChina, General Electric. And a lot of people sleep on iconic American brands such as General Electric, IBM. You'd be shocked at where they are. Wells Fargo, one of the oldest banks in the country. Toyota. Now, look. Toyota, the first car manufacturer on the list. Toyota. Second largest company, I mean the 12th largest company in the world is Apple. Apple, 12th, Apple, iPhone, iMac. You know, I'm actually doing this on the iMac as we talk. Then Royal Dutch Shell, Volkswagen Group, Germany. Okay, now look at these two car companies that have been around for a while. Now, if you don't know, Toyota and Volkswagen sell around the world. And in some countries, they do much better than they do here. Because there's some Americans who just have this notion that if it ain't here, it ain't happening, which is, you'll see, is way off. Now, HSBC, they've been around for a while. Chevron. Walmart, 16. There's been a lot of talk about Amazon kicking Walmart's ass, right? And I'm like, okay. I keep going on this. It's like Walmart's one of the biggest companies ever. Now, marking your mind where Walmart is, and also we'll see where Amazon shows up. Samsung, Citigroup, China Mobile. All of these companies that are super huge do something and sell a physical product or their financial companies. Either they make something or they manage money. Look at this. 1 through 20. They make something. China Mobile, look at that. Or they manage money. 1 through 20. With the lion's share, I mean, it's about split. But the, you know, this is one of the reasons that in 1950s, yeah, the 1950s, Detroit was the world's second largest economy after America. Detroit. Why? Because they made something. So remember that when you're listening to all this stuff about, you know, how to make money. Once again, Germany, Verizon, Bank of America. Never heard of this company. Microsoft, 25th. Benz, AT&T. Look at this stuff. You're seeing all kinds of things. Nestle. They make candy bars. Nestle. Switzerland. 30. Walmart's 12. Nestle's 30. Think about that. Finance company. Yes, in Spain. Look at this stuff. Johnson & Johnson, another iconic American brand. Procter & Gamble, China Life Insurance. What? Bank of Communications, China. If you hadn't noticed, you know, I'll just go ahead and drop it. China makes up over half the top 40. Think about that. Vodafone, been around for a long time. BP, AIG, IBM, BMW, Comcast. You see a lot of American companies down here in the 40s. A lot of these companies were in the top 10 at one point. I think IBM at one point was number one. Look at this. I'm speeding it up. Honda, General Motors, Honda Motors, TD Bank, Canada, Ford Motor Company. Okay, we are at number 75. Now, who thinks that Amazon's going to be in the top 100? International largest companies in the world. Because I always get this stuff about, yeah, you don't want to do Amazon. You're ignoring two of the largest. I look at the total package, the total deal. All right. So if you think Amazon is in the top 100, go ahead and put a one or two in the comments, right? Just go ahead right now as you're listening. Just put one or two. I'll pause and I'll just start scrolling. Go ahead. Make sure. Be honest. Don't cheat. All you folks who own that Amazon penis, on that Amazon penis, we're getting there. Merck, been around forever. I mean, these companies were established and making big money when I was a kid. Oh, Walt Disney Entertainment, CVS Health. You see it every on every corner. Oracle, Larry Ellison. Once again, the trend continues. Finance, or they make something. Finance, or they make something. United Technologies, ING, Coca-Cola, China Citic Bank, Morgan Stanley Bank, Nissan Motors. Uh-oh, wait a minute. Okay, I'm going to pause. If you put a one, go ahead and put another one in the comments that you think Amazon is the 100th top company in the world. Go ahead. Now, there's a lot of American companies that are still above it, you know. Well, if you thought it was in the top 100, you're wrong. Dead ass wrong. Okay. Now, Walmart, the one that Amazon's supposedly kicking their ass, you know, it's in the top 12. I mean, it's the top 20. Walmart. So, let's see. Let's look. A lot of companies, American Express. Because I'm going to start speeding this up. And I'm all right, you know. I'm going to pause. Look at all of these companies and what they do. Now, somebody sat down one day and said, I'm going to start this company. I remember when Hyundai came to America. It was this big ass joke, right? $84 billion. You know, this is really good because this is a great illustration. Okay. This is their sales, right? This is their profit. $7 billion off $84 billion in sales. Now I'm going to jump back up. Let's see. General Motors. 155 billion in sales, 3.9 billion. You see how this game is played? And let's see. Sales, profits. Yeah. Look at this. All right, so let's go back down there. Just to spare you some drama, who thinks Amazon's going to be in the top 200 world largest companies? Raise your put a three. You know, go ahead and put a three in the comments right now. Just go ahead, hit your phone, put a three if you think Amazon's going to be in the top 200. Because we've seen some heavy hitters, companies that you know, and some of you may even work for these companies. So we stopped it. Let's roll up. Where's that Hyundai? You see, Russian bank, Mexico, U.S. Bank Corp., one of the largest banks in the United States, international company, Mitsubishi. Look at this. Banco de Brazil, Smith Klein. I remember when they merged because Smith Klein was an American company and they got bought out by Glaxo. Caterpillar, been around forever. Now, Caterpillar, look at this. Now, $55 billion in sales and $3.7 billion in profit. Now, if you look at AIA, $25 billion in sales, but their grosses are crushing. I mean, they're crushing those grosses right here. Look at the profit on some of these companies. You know, I'll put a link or, well, actually, you could see it. Go right here. You see this Italy, China Telecom. Look at it. Bank of Montreal. Okay. All right. Who thinks Amazon, once again, is in the top 200? Please put a three in the comments. Please. Please do. And I will, let's see, roll up. I won't go too fast. China's all over the place. Heavy duty company here. Probably never even heard of them. Christian Dior. So see, we're starting to get some other things. I know this company spends like damn near like $2 or $3 billion a year in advertising. Yeah, billion with a B. Insurance, Christian Dior. All right, for those of you who put down a three, you know, that parcel service, you never thought about that. You know, you always talking about how, you know, people talking about like Amazon's pimping United Parcel Service. And it's like Amazon is an important part of UPS's business, but by no long shot, if Amazon said fuck UPS, would UPS go under? Now, with that said, who thinks, you know, you got your three? I'm just going to go ahead and Costco is 200. Costco. All right, so we're going to speed this thing up. I'm just going to show you some 3M, McDonald's, Lowe's. Because the reason I'm doing this is I am a digital citizen. I believe in the internet. I've made a lot of money on the internet. And it is the future. But it's the future. It's not here now. You got another 20 years to go out here in the world, create a physical business, somebody, some company that serves people, that does something substantial before the internet completely takes over. Yeah, you got another 20 years. That's one of the reasons that I have started some other companies, because there's a big window there. This is not going to disappear overnight. If you've got an idea and you think it'll take you 10 years to come to market, you're good. You're good, because a lot of people online are not making as much money as you think they are. And the reason I say that is, you know, you see the same things. You see the nice house. No, actually, you don't. You don't really see a house that much. You see the car. You see the watch. You see a lot of motivational stuff. I'm in a group. One of these guys posted some stuff, and then the group moderator kind of hit him with a serious question. And I was just like, he didn't believe it. It was just like, this dude's full of shit. Because all of this stuff about retiring early and making all this money and just coming online to help people, most people are too self-indulgent for that. Let's see. Okay, so if you think Amazon is in the top 300 international companies in the world, billion-dollar companies, you know, go ahead and put a five. Put a five. Cigna, they might actually manage your health insurance right now. A lot of companies out there, Canon, there's a lot of commerce out there. There's a lot of business. There's a lot of money out there other than fucking Amazon and eBay. So I'm just saying, and this is something that I knew, and I'm just doing this to educate you, just to kind of, you know, open your eyes to the possibilities. I mean, there's so much out there. Okay, so Southern Company, that's a regional company. 250. All right, Halliburton, everybody knows about that, unfortunately. Okay, so you put your four down. Kroger, grocery stores. Visa, you got it in your pocket right now. DBS, financial company, been around for a long time. Alibaba, huh? They ain't been, you know, that's fairly new. Who thought that Alibaba would be above Amazon? I know many people who are like, Amazon. No, and understand, I ordered some shit from Amazon today. I'm not hating. What I'm saying is expand your fucking perspective and stop being such a drone. All right. Here we go. All right, I'm going to speed it up. Ericsson, they do a lot of stuff. At one point, they were making some really nifty cell phones. I don't know if they still do. Ah, Facebook, 280. I know that was a surprise, right? Facebook. So let's see. All right. So if you think that Amazon is in the top 300, put a five in the comments. Just simple five. Just boom, boom, boom. And, you know, Nike. All right. Samsung Life Insurance. See, I just went ahead. I didn't, you know, drum it out and just hurt your feelings. No, not even the top 300. Okay, so we're going to just speed this up because it's going to be a bunch of stuff that you never heard of. Well, maybe some of you may have heard of. All right, so if you think Amazon is in the top 400, if you're in the top 400, put a six. Go ahead, put a six in the comment. I'm going to speed this up. And see, Chubb, they've been around a long time. Merck. And one of the things that, you know, United Continental Airlines, one of the things that I want you to understand is when you build a company for the long term, the methodology, the way that you set it up, the outlook is totally different than this internet stuff, which is very short-sighted, short-term, grab, grab, grab. Okay, Baxter, they do a lot of hospital stuff. Nokia, they're still making phones. All right, so you got your six down there. Let's see. And we are going. All right, because I'm gonna build up a little tension here. So you put your six down, right? You got your six. That's real good. That's real good. And let's see, SunTrust Banks. Local, it's an Atlanta company. Another billion-dollar company. Along with Home Depot, with Delta, Coca-Cola. There's a lot of billion-dollar companies here in Atlanta. And a lot of folks don't know that. Porsche. Yes, Porsche has their international headquarters in a racetrack here in Atlanta. Yep. When I used to live in Sandy Springs, I lived around a lot of the engineers. And they were letting me know when Porsche bought the old, I think it was a giant Ford plant by the airport, and then turned it into a racing center. Yep. Okay, so you got your six down. And, oh, Norfolk. Whoa. Railroads. Who would have thought that a railroad would be bigger than Amazon? Now, one of the reasons that I'm doing this is you see all of these companies and you see all of this money. Now, a lot of smart people in the world, internationally, there's a ton of really smart people. You don't think that some of these companies with this reach, this money, and this development is not getting, somebody in this list is getting ready to take Amazon on. They're going to have the money, they're going to have the talent, and they're going to have the time. This thing is, because like I said, right now, 8 to 12% of commerce is done online, which means 80 to 90 some percent is done out here. Huge, huge opportunity if you're looking at it from that standpoint. But if you're looking at it, like, if I don't go ahead and put out my little bullshit real quick, and that window will be closed. No, there's so many technologies that are coming. All right, so you got your six. Bam, you're wrong again. Not even in the top 400. Okay, so if you think Amazon is in the top, 500. Put an 8. Yeah, we're going to skip over 7. I think I did 7. No, put an 8. Yeah, put an 8 in the comments. And I'm going to just show you some more. Barclays, Bank, United Kingdom. I mean, I want you to just look at where a lot of this stuff is headquartered. And, some of these companies are going to become $100 billion companies. They're going to buy up the other guys. And they're going to expand all kinds of stuff. Kraft Food, been around forever. Macy's. Who would have thought Macy's would be ahead of Amazon? Bulk. This is what I'm talking about. There's stuff that you see and use and go to, making more money, have more value than Amazon. So let's see. Michelin Group. Just look at this. So you got your 8 down. And I'm going slow because just look at the opportunities. Just look at the opportunities here. Look at all the things that are available for you. Just look at this stuff. Voya. Colgate is above Amazon. Colgate. Where you got your toothpaste. Toothpaste. So. Someone's going to challenge Amazon. I'm not bullshitting. It's going to happen. I just think that because, as a digital citizen and, other people who only hang around digital citizens and have the insider knowledge, because those of us who are digital citizen, people who make our money purely online, we are a small group. We're a small group. Very, very small. I was at, when I used to do live meetups, I asked somebody, it's like, how many folks knew that someone that made their money purely online? I can go into a mall and probably today and walk around and not meet someone who's doing what I'm doing. Easily. This is a very small group. So that's why there's a ton of room for expansion. Well, there it is. 458. No profit. They lost money. They lost money. Let me say that again. They lost money. I'm going to say that one more time. Lost money. And everyone's talking about, Amazon's got this thing. They don't have to make money. At some point, they're going to have to make money. They're just going to have to. Because someone is going to eat their lunch if they keep playing this game. Because I don't care how smart you are, if you're consistently losing money, it is going to catch up with you. Now, Amazon's playing the game because they're spending their money and they're doing stuff. They're playing the game. But they're on this list because of their sales and their presence and they Jeff Bezos and everyone's smart. But look at this. Everyone else, they lost money. Well, no, they only made it. They didn't lose money. They made $865 million. Oh, my God. That's just chump change, compared to those guys. So if you put down an 8, you are a winner. Not in the top 400 companies. There are several companies. Walmart is 12. Let me put this again. Amazon is 458. Walmart is 12. Walmart has more money. Walmart has a larger presence. And Walmart's got some stuff in its DNA that Amazon doesn't. So it's going to be very, very interesting. So I just did this to, let people know the real deals. Men lie. Women lie. Numbers don't lie. There are 400 companies in terms of size, profit, sales, whatever you want to put, ahead of Amazon. 400. Actually, there's 450, but I just, just to, 400. And see, I'll go down the list a little bit. And let's see, the top 500, it's all over the world. China's everywhere. So let's see, what's 500? Compass, that's interesting. Ecolab, they do a lot of hospital stuff. China, 500, China, number one and number 500, China. All right, so let me go ahead and just drop some stuff on you. And Alibaba was way ahead of Amazon. Think about that. Way ahead. So I want you to think about this, and this is something they're going to do. What about if Alibaba built a website very similar to Amazon where you can order the stuff direct, much cheaper, and get it just as fast? That's going to happen. I know it's going to happen. And people are like, oh my God. Like I said, let's just go back to, let's roll up here. Let's see. Citigroup, Walmart stores. I'm sorry, they were 16. They weren't 12. Way more sales, way more profit. And let's just be really clear. Walmart is sitting on a ton of cash in their corporate operation. They're sitting on billions. And then they're still making billions every year. Telling you, it's going to be very, very interesting in the future. Apple, $44 billion. Their profit margins are insane for a company of its size and with its manufacturing processes. It's insane. If you look at what they pulled in terms of profit compared to other folks, they're killing it. They are just killing it. And if Apple wanted to duke it out with Amazon, they could. Because not only do they have the money and the marketplace reach, they have the intellectual DNA as well. Apple's playing this game, but if Apple really wanted to jump into the fray, and they may at some point, Amazon's going to have a problem. Because if Apple and Alibaba and those other companies, which is going to happen, start jumping into it, because e-commerce is going to be huge. Because people are like, oh, it's tapped out, it's too hard. If you're thinking about fucking Amazon and eBay, yeah. But if you're thinking about starting your own website, creating your own brand, potential is sick. It's wide open, because when you create your own brand, no one else can duplicate you. Get it? So there's a lot of people up here who can get into the mix, got the money, the talent, and the time, and it's going to happen. You think these companies are just going to sit back and let Amazon just take over this market and make all this money? Are you insane? There are 300 companies who could do it if they so desire. And I guarantee you, some of these manufacturing companies are going to get in. A lot of these companies are going to create their own websites. They're going to have a very much like an Amazon experience, and they're going to start eating Amazon's lunch. I'm telling you. Google, if Google wanted to get in there and do it, Google's got some insane profits too. $66 billion in sales, 13 good profit margins. Look at this. This is kind of scary. $352 million in sales. Look at BP's profit margins compared to Google's, and look at the sales. You know, those numbers are very, very important. But BP's really entrenched. A lot of their infrastructure is paid for. They're all over the place. So that's another thing. IBM, you know, there's just a lot of people. Comcast, they're going to get into it. I can tell you that Comcast is going to get into it. So, and as of this morning, Amazon announced video. Now, that's going to be really interesting. Since I'm a video dude, I'm going to play with it, because they're not the only ones getting into this space. You're going to have a point where a creator can create a movie and like go to Sony, do a distribution deal, put the movie out for like, you know, $1.50 and sell it around the world. And that kid's going to be a billionaire in a year. This is the world we live in. These are the potentials. This is the possibility. This is the stuff that is here, and this is stuff that's coming. And I'm doing this not to beat up on you, but to, you know, just kind of like slap the shit out of you so you can get off of that train and actually expand your opportunities, expand your reach, expand your potential. So here are 455 companies that make more money than Amazon. So when someone comes to me and talking about like they're the largest, blah, 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 I'm like, playboy, playgirl, talk to someone who's uninformed. Now, I just informed you of what's out there, what's possible, what's going on. And this is what's funny about this list. In 5 years, there are going to be companies in that top 100 that don't even exist yet. In 5 years, that's how fast this thing's going. Maybe one of you will be part of that company, and maybe one of you will start that company, because tech is going to crush this stuff. You know, there's a lot of people who's like, hey, you know, why you get out of resale if you're making so much money? Simple. Intellectual property, as I did in my intellectual property video, made today could make you millions for years. When you buy and sell something, once you make that sale and it's not a recurring revenue model, it's over. But intellectual property, like Prince, he's passed on. Elvis has passed on. Michael Jackson's passed on. Their intellectual property is making billions of dollars today, and they're dead. That's the power of intellectual property. And that's why I did not get back into the storage auction game. That's why I didn't get back to flipping stuff, because I can make way more money doing what I'm doing. Way more. I'm talking about a staggering amount more. I made good money in the storage auction business. But never in my life have I been able to sit at home and make more money in a month than the average person makes in a year. That shit has never happened to me before. And that's why I'm doing what I'm doing. That's why I'm encouraging. That's why I'm ringing up the digital citizen bell, because there's a lot of you with the talent and the ability to do the same. It's probably going to take you 2 to 5 or 7 years to amp up. But if you live long enough, you can do it. If you take the blinders off and stop being afraid of hard shit, you can do it. This is out here. This is the possibility. This is what's out here. These companies didn't just come from air. Somebody sat down and decided to start all of them. One person. One. All right. So if you like the contents of this video, be sure to subscribe. Be sure to get your free 19 courses. And if you like the content of the video, if you like your free courses, do me a favor. Refer 3 people to the Hustler Kung Fu brand. Also, if you find value in the courses, the channel, this video, pay what you want. The links will be the first comment below. So with that, I'll see you in the next video.